What's up? Welcome back to my channel. For today's video, I decided to do a makeup and skincare crossover video where I'm like talking about skincare that you need to do so that makeup does not harm your skin. Yeah, something on those lines. So if you're new to my channel, first things first, you should subscribe to my channel. If you're into beauty and makeup related content, I think you'll really enjoy your time here, and I upload every Sundays. So please click on that big red subscribe button down below and also on the bell icon right next to it and join this beautiful family. And now let's dive straight into some tips that you need to keep in mind if you have sensitive skin and you really enjoy applying makeup. Okay, so first things first, I've heard a lot of people say all kinds of things about makeup, like makeup is the reason you're getting acne, or makeup is the reason you're going to spoil your skin, or it's going to give you aging in the future, all sorts of things, and you're beautiful just like that. But then when I had acne, I was not just beautiful just like that. Like, I've all heard it all at this point, and I just want to say something very bold and clear out there, that if you like wearing makeup, no matter what your skin type, no matter if you have like a face full of acne or you have none of it, you should do just what you want to do, not listen to anybody out there, no matter what they want to say. You do you, and like the world, okay? I'm not gonna say the word because it's not gonna monetize my video, but just like screw the world, let them say what they want to say. Because I've had like a full phase of cystic acne right in the beginning when I started YouTube. If you see my old videos from back in the day, you will see that I had like a face full of cystic acne, and that's what really got me into makeup in the first place, because I was not at all confident in my skin. I used to feel very insecure about my acne, feel very insecure about going out in public like that, and always get comments about do something for your skin, or what is that, or go visit a doctor, do you want my dermatologist number. I've heard it all at this point, and it's very frustrating, and that's the reason I first dove into makeup, to just buy a full coverage foundation to cover up this face was my only goal. And then slowly and steadily I discovered that I really enjoy doing makeup and enjoy the whole process of it, and it's very therapeutic for me. So today, even though I have clearer skin, I still continue to do makeup, and I continue to apply a full face of makeup and a full face of glam when I'm going out there, because I don't give two shits about what anybody has to say about me. So I think you need to have that attitude when you have to deal with so many people's opinion on social media and out in the world. You need to really let go of people's opinions and do what you want to do. So first, I'm going to tell you all that. Secondly, I need you all to keep all these myths aside. If you have acne, makeup is not going to make it any worse. I have applied full face of glam when I had really active acne, and it did not do anything to aggravate my acne. Something that I had was very internal. My internal hormonal imbalance was giving me acne, and curing it internally has helped me solve it. I have a separate video on that, and I'm gonna leave that link in the description section if you're here just to know how to get rid of acne. But today I'm here to tell you how to apply your makeup without like doing any harm to your skin at all. So diving right into the tips, the first tip I want to give you all is skin hygiene. Very, very important. When you have acne, or even if you don't have acne, you're out there, you're constantly exposing your skin to pollutants, or even in your house, like I have a dog, there's constantly dog fur on my face, he's licking my face, there's pollution outside, there's construction work, plus you keep getting pus-filled acne, and anytime your acne breaks, that pus can spread to a new point and then like make the bacteria spread all over your face and spread your acne. So skin hygiene is very important. You need to keep your skincare very fixed, especially when you have acne prone skin. You need to make sure that you're cleansing your skin twice a day, and especially before applying makeup, do cleanse your skin, do apply your toner, your moisturizer, or your serum, or both of them, and then dive into your makeup. So first thing, skin hygiene, keep your skin clean always before you do your makeup, and also your hands clean. Wash your hands first thing, and then wash your face, and then go and dive into makeup. Second tip I want to give you is makeup hygiene. Makeup can be very unhygienic if you keep on storing it. If you're a makeup hoarder, you don't realize how long it's been that you've washed your brushes, how long it's been that you've washed your beauty blender, and how many times you're putting that same contaminated hand in that bottle of foundation, or the cushion foundation, or the compact or loose powder. So those things that go bare on your face, like primer, which goes directly from the pot to your face, or foundation that goes directly from your hands to your face, those kind of things you need to keep really hygienic. Like when I had active acne, and even today I'm a big OCD when it comes to cleaning my beauty blenders and my brushes. I make sure that I'm cleaning them once a week, at least brushes once a week, and beauty blender every time I want to use it. Every time I want to use my beauty blender, I go pump some Dettol hand wash on it, like scrub it clean, and then only squeeze all the water out and then start applying my foundation. Very, very cautious about doing that, because you need to make sure that, like, I use beauty blender for everything. It's touching my skin directly, it's in direct contact with my skin, and any dirt on my skin, I'm gonna like spread it all over my face, or whatever dirt has contamination has sat on the beauty blender, all this white is going to spread to my face. So it's very important to keep your makeup products very clean. You can buy rubbing alcohol and keep it with you, or like Dettol hand wash to wash your brushes, to wash your beauty blenders is what I do. I don't keep rubbing alcohol with me, but I always make sure my hands are very clean before I'm diving into any pot kind of containers, like primers or foundations which come in a pot. And you have to dig your hands and then apply to your face. You need to really clean your hands before you do that. Third thing I want to say is, do not apply makeup directly on an acne which has just burst. An acne which has just burst is an active acne. It has burst, the pus is still leaking, it's an active infection. Applying your foundation on that is not going to help that scar to heal nicely, because yes, makeup and foundation does have a lot of chemical in it, and if you're going to put it on bare bones, like it's like putting a bare burn wound, if you're putting a lot of chemical, if it's going to burn more, it's not going to heal well. So don't do that. If you have an active acne, let it and it has just burst, let it heal, and only then go in for makeup. Go with that acne out in the open, does not matter. And if you desperately need to go for an occasion or a function, then try to put like a spot treatment on it, like maybe those patches that you get by Dr. Belmer, those patches, and then put foundation on that. Or put like your ointment and then let that ointment dry and then put foundation on that. That is only SOS. If you really need makeup to save your life and you cannot get out of the house without makeup, then do that. Otherwise, let that wound heal, let your acne heal. Once the zit is completely healed, then maybe you can once again dive into your makeup. Fourth thing I want to mention is, for a face full of acne, or even if not full of acne, some other kind of allergies or some kind of redness, some kind of inflammation, try icing. Icing really, really helps. It's a total remedy. It can calm your inflammation instantly, and also a great thing that ice does is that it causes vasoconstriction. So immediately all the pores and all the blood vessels which are very open and your skin is inflamed because it's healing right now, when you have acne or when you have redness or allergies, it's healing, and that's why there's a lot of blood supply to your skin. So applying ice will kind of like decrease the blood supply for that temporary time, and also like close out your pores and everything. And then going in with the skincare routine, whatever you do, your moisturizer and your serum, and then let your skin sit for 5 to 10 minutes and then apply makeup. Icing really will help with active anything on your face or even your wounds. Like when you get hurt, how do you immediately go and apply ice and then you feel a lot better? Your skin will feel a lot better. When I had active acne, ice was my favorite best friend. I used to come home and clean my face and then immediately ice all my acne to calm my skin down. Okay, the fourth tip I want to give you, I think it's the fourth one, is before applying makeup, if you have acne, again and again I'm saying the whole acne, you can keep a tag of how many times I say acne, but you should apply spot treatment. Do something for your skin before you do your makeup. Like I said, keep your skincare on for 5 to 10 minutes and only then dive into your makeup, because let your skin really take in what you first put in and then layer all your makeup products over it. Just apply some sort of spot treatment, maybe a tea tree oil. Just dip your earbud, a clean earbud, and put it on your acne, or like clindamycin ointment or something that's clear. Like femsenol is an ointment which dries up acne really soon and it's clear, so I used to use that. I used to just dip my earbud in that ointment and apply it on my acne, let it dry completely, apply moisturizer in the rest of my area, and then apply my makeup. So that is something that will help your acne heal and breathe despite having so much makeup on. The fifth tip I want to give you is, do not do a cake face of makeup. yes, you will feel that because you have so much of acne going on, you need full coverage foundation, full coverage powder, high coverage concealer. No, that's not the truth. Try to use something. Yes, you can use. I'm also a full coverage kind of person. I like my full pigment foundation, but don't keep layering or keep building product where you already have so much going on your skin. Don't apply concealer just right to the areas that you have acne. You're not doing anything good. In fact, the more you layer exactly where you have a problem, you're going to make that area look the most emphasized and the most bright on camera. Like, the rest of the face is going to look very decent and most of the focus will go to your acne. So don't do that. Just apply the same amount of product all over your skin. Treat your skin very equally and apply like an even layer of product, not too much, not too little, and then go out there. The sixth tip I want to give you is, when you're applying highlighters, you need to be a little careful with that. That's a little sad part. When you have acne or when you have textured skin and if you're not exfoliating regularly, which I really, really recommend, exfoliate at least once a week with a chemical exfoliator rather than a physical exfoliator, because acne, horrible, horrible. Physical exfoliators are horrible for skin in general. Try using an AHA or BHA product once a week at least on your skin. I have a video on using acids and everything. All the skincare videos, I'm going to leave it in the description section. But try exfoliating once a week so that you are free of texture from your skin. And apart from that, also when you're applying your makeup, try to keep your highlighters. If you like really love highlighters, for the love of highlighters, just keep it on the tops of your cheekbones. Do not apply pressed powder or compact powder or blush that has a lot of shimmer in it. Shimmer will emphasize your texture and your makeup will look really bad. So for a good makeup application, I want to suggest that do not apply products that have shimmer or specks of glitter in them. Try to use matte blushes, matte powders, matte everything. A setting spray with an illumination is good because it will add some life and glow to your skin. And a highlighter just on the tops of your cheekbones where you don't have any texture or don't have any acne going on. So you can usually, people don't get acne on their cheekbones. Like, I used to get it right here and here, so you don't really get over here and here. So there you can apply highlighter. The rest of the face, I would advise that you go in for a matte finish. The second last thing I want to mention, the seventh tip, which might come off as rude but it's very, very essential, is that do not share your makeup. You feel like whenever your friends ask for makeup, you need to give them. You cannot say no. That was a big problem I had. I would never be able to say no. And I would share my makeup generously with everyone, but that was only inviting a lot of bacteria into my makeup. I still do share my makeup. It's not that I say no to my friends for anything. But when it comes to foundation, concealers, primers, these three things I do not share, and my beauty blenders. Like, whenever my friends come over for getting their makeup done, I tell them these four things you get your own, and rest everything you can use mine. You can use my eyeshadow, you can use my blush, you can use my highlight, you can use everything which does not touch my face directly. Because my brushes, my blenders, my foundation, all of that touches my face directly, and I don't want constant bacteria contact. It's best if you don't share highlighters, blush and bronzers as well. But we live in a community, we have to, like, of course share. You cannot like be like, oh no, I'm a touch me not, touch my makeup. You can't do that, and I don't do that. But when it comes to like direct hygiene, there is where I draw the line. Like, just get that much stuff of your own and you can use the rest of my makeup. Even mascaras are genuinely not to be shared, because you can share a lot. Like, it's like right in contact with your eyes. So kajal, mascara, primers, foundation, concealer, these five things, and your tools, your makeup tools, do not share them with your friends. No matter how rude you come off as, tell them to Google skin hygiene and see what all you can spread to each other. Even if both of y'all don't have some skin infection, both of y'all are gonna get some new skin infection. So for both of your sakes, do not share your makeup. And the last thing I wanna mention is, keep your skin clean when you go to bed. Keep it really, really clean. Really remove all your makeup. Use a micellar water, use an oil-based remover. I used to do a lot of steps to remove my makeup when I used to have a lot of acne. And even today, I'm very, very strict when it comes to, no matter how late it is, no matter if I come home from a wedding at 4 o'clock in the morning, I will remove everything and go to bed. And you should do that. No laziness when it comes to removing your makeup, because applying makeup is a task, but removing is a task in itself. So you have to do that. what I do is like take a cleanser, take an oil like a Johnson's baby oil, remove all of that. Then I should take Bioderma because it's very, very good for sensitive skin. I take Garnier micellar water now because it's more affordable, and like pump that. Really use 3-4 cotton pads, remove everything. Cleanse your face with a face wash. Once again, go with micellar water, and then use a toner for any excess product that you have. Do your skincare and then go to bed. Your skin deserves that after you've put it through all that makeup and the evening full of strutting around in your makeup. So you need to give that for your skin. Do not sleep with your makeup. That is injustice to your skin. So that's about it. That is all I had to share when it comes to makeup and skin and putting them together. You can wear your makeup even if you have acne. Don't let anybody tell you not to do that. But always keep all of these small, small things in mind. Mostly everything revolves around hygiene and skincare. And then you can go ahead and wear that makeup very beautifully. And tag me in your photos if you follow all of these steps. Follow me on Instagram if you're not already doing that, because I keep sharing one or two tips here and there on my stories, which I don't compile into videos. Subscribe to my channel if you're new here, and share this video with all your friends and your loved ones who are suffering from acne and who are scared to apply makeup. Go share this video, and also leave your comments down below. Let me know if you were already doing some of these steps, and if there are any more steps that you know which will help acne girls wear their makeup confidently. I will see you in my next video. Bye guys, love you all.